people are concerned about Monsanto that it's gaining monopoly. I don't think Monsanto is like the Microsoft. It is a Pinochet of the food world. And that's what I told Robert Shapiro. You shouldn't be concerned about being labeled as Microsoft and the monopoly and the rest. You're the Pinochet of the food world. And I say that because it's not just about information that is being provided or not being provided to consumers in terms of how safe the technology is, how safe everything is. The issue is the tactics that they've adopted in terms of suppressing people's opinion or anyone who's tried to say anything about it.
I think that people, like, to use an example, people like Robert Shapiro, they very rarely put themselves in a place where they're going to hear any dissent. The event that he was pied at was the State of the World Forum, which is a bunch of self-congratulatory wealthy liberals patting each other on the back. Nobody there is going to be saying, you know, you're wrong, what you're doing is wrong, what you're doing is dangerous and frightening and bad. Like, people aren't going to get close enough to him to say stuff like that. So they very rarely hear any of that dissent. It goes through, like, you know, his secretaries, his, you know, his underlings before it would ever get to him. And so getting a pie in the face is, first of all, like I say, it's a message of we know who you are and we don't agree with what you're doing. And it's also, like, it puts a face on that dissent. Like, here's this person, and they're willing to come right up to you and put the pie in your face. Like, we really don't like what you're doing.
And I believe that the state of the world in the next century will be more hopeful for more people as a result of the wise application of biological knowledge. Thank you.
They can poke fun at society and the rulers and the world. And a very interesting clown is the Hopi clown, the Hopi Pueblo. If you're familiar with that clown, it's called the tsuku or the kosher, and they wear black and white stripes and they have corn braids. And they would be a perfect mirror of everything of the Hopi world. So they did everything that was un-Hopi. And the only rule that they had to follow was that they could break every rule.
Thank you.
The American public understands the impact and the message that is put forth by a pie. I mean, think of Three Stooges, think of the Marx Brothers. It's very, very plain what is happening when a pie is delivered.
Pieing is part of our culture. Pieing, it's used in the circus by clowns, and even Johnny Carson used to get pied all the time as part of the shtick, and many.
I think the history of pie throwing shows that it's a form of visual Esperanto. It's a universal language. Everyone understands the pie in the face. And in fact, the headline of the Examiner after the recent elections was GOP receives pie in the face. There you have it.
There's the metaphor. Well, here.
Popular as this jest has always been, however, it cannot compare with the ribald connotations associated with the dispatch of an edible missile. First, the simple, straightforward, offensive deposit.
In your face! Charlie Hurwitz, in your face! Milton Friedman, there's poetic justice dripping from your chin. In your face! Bob Shapiro, in your face! They're the people's heroes, and you're just a notch upon their rolling pin. Yes, you're just a notch upon their rolling pin.
We're pie-throwing anarchists. I mean, we don't believe in relying on the mainstream media for much of anything, but, you know, there's the possibility of as the situationists would have referred to it, of détournement. Of to détourne is to alter the spectacle that, you know, for instance, mainstream media presents, and to take their spectacle and just spin it around. The three main TV networks are owned by Disney, by Westinghouse, and by General Electric. So we have the same corporations that are destroying us through nuclear energy and nuclear warfare, through infotainment, which creates a set of values that are completely opposed to any kind of sustainable, any kind of peaceable process. So we have the situation where the same corporations that are destroying us and destroying our future are presenting us with the news.
All right. I'll make sure they get it to you. Wonderful. Talk to you soon. This is Agent Salmonberry, like the fish. You got it. All right.
You know, their use of the internet has been such that there are right-wing think tanks like the RAND Corporation that regularly publish reports documenting the fact that the Zapatistas, more than perhaps any other uprising in modern times, have effectively bypassed the regular filters, the regular circuits through which veins of dissent are cast aside and never get to the people themselves.
It is part of a bigger challenge that has faced every recent mayor. And now it's Willie Brown's turn.
Like a couple of notable people before him, Willie Brown was targeted by activists with pies.
Well, one of the ways that this helps the homeless is that people are aware that one of the reasons that the pieing of Mayor Brown happened was to bring attention to what we've called the Great Homeless Sweep. There are new programs being put into effect as we speak, called San Francisco Cares and a Three Drunks and You're Out program, which are designed to sweep homeless people off the street.
If anything, the article on the front page of the New York Times makes it very clear that the programs that Mayor Brown and his administration have outlined are not addressing the needs. They're pouring money into Mission Rock facility, and that facility is going to be turned down. There are 7 people for every 1 bed in this city, and there are 1,700 people being turned away every month from beds.
Thank you for calling the Great Sweep Hotline. This message will repeat in Cantonese and Spanish. The next Great Sweep is Saturday, November 7th.
154 people died on the streets of San Francisco last winter.
Who's
accountable for that? You know, we're in a crisis time, and...
So when are we going to change the laws to address that? You know, how many pies need to be thrown before we're going to change the laws?
Yeah, I guess we'll see.
Brown says he hopes to have groundbreaking for the new stadium when the Giants move to their new stadium in the year 2000.
And just as the mayor was getting all warmed up and ready to make that rather dramatic announcement, he got a surprise today, one that left him momentarily speechless and stone-faced. Like a couple of notable people before him, Willie Brown was targeted by activists with pies. Brenda Burdett has the story.
Hey, you gotta be quiet for a second. This was called, of course, to announce the Great Sweep and to kick off the Great Sweep. But this morning, we have something even more dramatic to talk about, and that's the San Francisco...
Those responsible for the not-so-sweet surprises are members of the Biotic Baking Brigade, also called the BBB, a self-proclaimed activist group fighting a number of problems, including downtown development, cutting of the redwoods, and homelessness.
That allows people to have a laugh at the expense of rich and powerful and otherwise unaccountable figures.
The kinds of pies used are different for each person and carry a special significance. For example, the all-American symbol apple pie was used for Charles Hurwitz, the CEO of Pacific Lumber, because the organization feels cutting the redwoods is un-American.
So far, 5 notable people in business and politics have been hit, and the BBB plans to pie many more.